Millions of Americans in southeast Texas facing brutally hot conditions without relief after Beryl knocked out power to a large portion of the region. More than 2 million homes and businesses are still without electricity as temperatures reach above 38 degrees Celsius. Several gas stations in Houston, the state's largest city, were closed Tuesday because of the outage, forcing residents to wait in long lines at the remaining open gas stations. Tropical storm Beryl barreled into Texas Monday, flooding highways, damaging homes, and downing power lines in its path. It left at least 7 dead in the state. Two of the Philippines' great amateur boxers chosen as the country's flag bearers for the upcoming Paris Olympics, Jack Batallones reports.
After winning a silver medal in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics, boxer Nesty Petesio admits she is contemplating retirement, especially since there are plans to remove boxing from the 2028 Los Angeles Olympics.
Kung nabasa niyo yung balita, wala na nung Olympics ang boxing sa LA. Yung bakit di pagpapatuloy ko pa yung next Olympics? Di pa naman po sure yun. Dinidiscuss pa po yun. And, yes, pero tumatanda na po ako.
If the Paris Olympics is her last chance at the Olympics, it will be extra special for her. Aside from competing again for the coveted gold, she has also been chosen as the flag bearer for the Philippines.
Sobrang blessed, honored po na isa ako sa napiling maging flag bearer po. Pero sa totoo, reaction ko talaga dun, ha? Talaga? Kasi po, ang nasa isip ko po talaga magpa-flag si EJ and Caloy. Sila po talaga. So never kong iniisip na magiging isa po ako dun. So sobrang thankful po ako.
Alongside her as flag bearer is fellow boxer Carlo Paalam.
Sobrang saya po kasi dala yung, hindi lang apelido yung dala namin po eh. Kasi buong Pilipinas yung dala namin. Tapos naglalakad kami hawak ng Pilipinas.
Petesio and Paalam are among the few Filipino boxers chosen to be flag bearers for the country in the Olympics. The list includes Manfredo Alipala in 1964, Arlo Chavez in the Barcelona Olympics, Reynaldo Galido in 1996, and Yumir Marshall in the Tokyo Olympics. In 2008, Manny Pacquiao was a special choice as the country's flag bearer. David Nepomuceno from athletics was the first flag bearer for the country in the 1924 Olympics. Before weightlifter Heidi Lynn Diaz brought home the country's first gold medal in the Games, she was the flag bearer in the 2012 London Olympics. Meanwhile, the athletes will wear the Sinag Barong designed by Francis Libiran.
Maganda po yung design po. Tsaka Pilipinong-Pilipino po talaga.
A few weeks before the start of the Paris Olympics, judoka Kiyomi Watanabe, who served as a flag bearer in the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, will return to Paris. Jack Batallones, ABS-CBN News.
A Philippine lawmaker dispels fears about the use of nuclear energy. This after the landmark nuclear deal between the Philippines and the U.S. officially took effect last week. The 123 agreement enables the Philippines to bring in nuclear material, equipment, and components from the U.S. The push to develop nuclear energy in the Philippines has drawn criticisms from several groups, but House Committee on Nuclear Energy Chairperson Marco Huanco says nuclear is one of the safest forms of energy.
If you look at the history of nuclear power over the last 60 years, except for Chernobyl, there was no mortality in any nuclear accident. Meaning, it is the safest energy source of all, compared to all, including wind and solar. And the implication is that nuclear, because it replaces the more deadly forms of energy, which is coal and gas, it actually saves lives. It's bad to be this dependent on fossil fuels. 80% of our electricity comes from imported fossil fuels.
Manila and Washington signed their 123 agreement November of 2023 after only a year of negotiations. For House lawmaker Franz Castro, the speed at which a deal came into force is questionable. She plans to seek a House probe on the deal.